Today's topic is for everyone out there who is investigating faith. And we're going to talk about the three longings built into every human heart. If you're watching this video and you're saying to yourself, life isn't really giving me what I want. I feel let down. I feel a lack of satisfaction. Maybe the problem is that you're looking for the good life in all the wrong places. See, built into all of our hearts is a longing for love, a longing for purpose, and a longing for answers. Let's start with love. We're all looking for love, and sometimes we'll turn to it from any source. But ultimately, here's what I want you to know. Ultimately, this desire comes from God because we're not meant to do life alone. I don't know if you've heard of this guy, Glenn Wolf. He actually is famous for something that really nobody wants to be famous for. He holds the Guinness World Record for the most marriages. Check it out. He was married 30 times. And the sad thing about his story, well, there's a lot of sad things, but the main sad thing is at his death, none of his wives or kids showed up. Genesis 2:18, it says this, "Then the Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper who is just right for him." See, this is the account of the creation of human beings. And according to the Bible, God created human beings to be in relationship. It's not good for people to be alone. You were created to be connected to people. So if you're looking for love in all the wrong places, maybe it's time to look for it in the Bible. Maybe it's time to look for it in God Himself. And here's the second thing. We all want our lives to matter, and we'll pursue success, money, and more, but true fulfillment comes from God. If you're looking for purpose, I believe you can't find it outside of a pursuit of God. God said this to the Old Testament prophet Jeremiah, chapter 1, verse 5. He said, "I knew you before I formed you in your mother's womb. Before you were born, I set you apart." Have you ever considered that that could also be true of you, that God knew you before you were even born, that God had a plan for you even before you had a plan for yourself? I love how the Apostle Paul describes this in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. He says, "For we are God's masterpiece. He has created us anew in Christ Jesus so we can do the good things He planned for us long ago." Your life is not accidental. It's not pointless or purposeless. If you want your life to matter, find fulfillment only in God. And here's the third thing. We all need to know why. Why is life hard? Why is there so much evil in the world? People have wondered for centuries about this, and I believe the Bible offers the answers we seek. Back to Genesis, the first chapter in the whole Bible, chapter 1. In verse 31, it says that God looked over all He had made, and He saw that it was very good. And my point is that God created everything good. So that means evil and suffering and sickness was not part of God's original plan that entered into the world because of sin in the world. Romans 8 in the New Testament explains this further. It says in verse 20, "Against its will, all creation was subjected to God's curse, but with eager hope, the creation looks forward to the day when it will join God's children in glorious freedom from death and decay." In other words, suffering is the result of broken humanity in a broken world that we live in. Just look around. It's pretty obvious that that's true. But the good news of the Bible is that someday this suffering will end. And in the meantime, we can take comfort in the God who suffers with us. Dietrich Bonhoeffer was a guy who understood this all too well. He stood up against the evil Nazi regime, and it cost him his life. And here was the heart of his message in those days: only the suffering God can help. And the reason for that is because God Himself suffered with us. He suffered for us. So evil and suffering, all of that only makes sense in the context of a biblical worldview. So if you're longing for any of these things, love, purpose, or just answers to life, maybe it's time to look for it in the author of life itself. Maybe it's time to look for it in a pursuit of God.